There is a false religion that is taking root in our land that is not a new religion. It just has a new name. It is the religion of political correctness and the preaching of tolerance. Tolerance of sin and of that which is wrong, when God calls us to hate sin because it separates us from Him and is destructive to our lives. James 4:4 says, "Don't you know that friendship with the world is hatred toward God? Anyone who chooses to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God." Political correctness is an evil teaching that is seeping into God's church and is attempting to politically correct the Word of God. God tells us not to change anything in His Word. Do not add anything to it or take anything away from it. If God's Word is politically corrected, it is no longer God's Word. It is a false teaching. The religion of political correctness seeks to change the definition of biblical terms, especially the term grace. Grace is being redefined as tolerance. We are able to experience God's grace when we come to the realization that we need to turn away from doing things the way we feel like doing things, the way we want to do things, and realize we need to turn to God and do things the way He created us to do things. Paul asks us in Romans 6:15, "What then? Shall we sin because we are not under law but under grace?" By no means, he exclaims. Another way of looking at this is that we need to turn away from being the Lord of our own lives and believe in Jesus as the Lord of our lives. God tells us in 2 Timothy 4:3 through 4 that the time will come when men will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myths. We need to make sure that the teachings we believe in line up with God's Word. The only way to know whether or not a teaching is from the Lord is to be in His Word for ourselves. We can all go right to the source. In Matthew 7:21 through 23, Jesus tells us, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and in your name drive out demons and perform many miracles?' Then I will tell them plainly, 'I never knew you. Away from me, you evildoers.'" And in Matthew 7:13 through 14, he tells us, "Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life, and only a few find it." There are many false teachers teaching people that they are okay with God when they really are not. They only teach the promises of God without the conditions to those promises. This causes people to believe that they can be right with God and be in rebellion to God in His ways at the same time. "For certain men, whose condemnation was written about long ago, have secretly slipped in among you. They are godless men, who changed the grace of our God into a license for immorality and denied Jesus Christ, our only sovereign and Lord." Jude 1:4. People are being led to believe in Jesus as a Santa Claus or a ticket to get into heaven, but we don't have to believe in Him as the Lord of our lives. In political correctness, there is no room for God's teaching on repentance, sin, or obedience to God. If you teach on these subjects, you are labeled as unloving, judgmental, not showing grace, and are called being religious. It is written, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God" in Romans 3:23. And, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord" Romans 6:23. Throughout the Bible, Old and New Testaments, God calls us to repent, believe, trust, and obey Him. In John 14:23 through 24, Jesus tells us, "If anyone loves me, he will obey my teaching. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. He who does not love me will not obey my teaching. These words you hear are not my own. They belong to the Father who sent me. If we truly believe, we will believe that Jesus really is God. He really is good. He really does have a perfect plan and purpose for each of our lives. We will desire to obey Him because of the great love and sacrifice He made for us. We will believe that what He commands us to do will be good for us, and that He commands us not to do certain things because they are not good for us and will separate us from Him. In Luke 13:3, Jesus tells us, "But unless you repent, you too will all perish." The good news is that, from the beginning, God has had a plan to rescue all of us from our sins through His Son Jesus Christ and what He did on the cross. That if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. Romans 10:9-10.